Redefining in action. The majority of leaders and managers out there are very good at what they do. And one of the challenges that they have is they spend a lot of time and energy unnecessarily in places they don't like to. They don't want to. It doesn't yield any of the results that they're looking for. Redefining will change that. It will take less time and decrease risk. It's no different than the economics of thinking. You're moving the thinking up front instead of doing all that action that you were used to or oriented before. So what I'd like to do is take a quick look at the redefining process, which culminates in what's called a what would it take statement. So what we're going to do is take a look at the redefining process, which is on your screen. On the left-hand side, you've got the steps, and on your right, you've got that cyclone again that's come back from the enterprise thinking model. And there are three different distinct steps within there. The first part is you're going to create that challenge statement. Then you're going to scrub it, clean it. Then you're going to move on to a redefined should statement and then a what would it take statement. So let's start with the original challenge statement. Remember I said to you, for you in the last video to write down what your biggest challenge is? Well, that would be considered the starting point of your challenge statement. That would be it. That's what you consider. Now, it's a draft, I know, and probably after what I've just said in the last video, you've already altered it. Well, that's part of redefining. It's finding the clarity in what you're really trying to ask. So what you're going to do is write that challenge statement, and then what we're going to do is scrub it. Now, I'm going to give you six different scrubbing criteria that you can use to be able to look at that challenge statement to identify whether it works for you or not. And there are many other tools that we could have given you, but these six are the core, and if you stick to them, I guarantee you the results will improve drastically. It's more or less about wordsmithing and finding the right words. By writing down your challenge statement, you force yourself to write something as clearly and concisely, as focused as you can, so someone can have exactly what they need to be able to understand what you're talking about. And just that process alone will be transformational. What do I really want to write? What do I have to say? Now, now that you have that in front of you, what we're going to do is move to scrubbing. And what scrubbing means is you're going to look at that statement and see if it matches the criteria. Now, I'm going to go over them in six different videos and the seven to culminate. But in this one, what I will say is this. What happens is you have a challenge statement. You look at it. You see if the criteria works. If it doesn't work, you clean it and start again. And then you have to look at that criteria again. You can't skip to the second one. You now have to reevaluate it. If you do the first criteria, do the second and it passes, and it gets to the third and it doesn't pass, you don't get to move back one or re-clean it up. You clean it up and start again for number one. I'm being honest with you when I say that I have seen people with 20 some odd challenge statements rewritten and rewritten and rewritten before they found the one that they were comfortable with, the one that helped them achieve their desired outcome. I've seen them at 6, I've seen them at 9. However, inside of their head, they're probably rewriting it multiple times before they actually put it down. So the key to this is don't skip. I know I'm saying it again, don't skip. You've got to use each step and each criteria. So we're going to move to the first criteria, and I will reiterate this at the end on the 7th so that you have an understanding of you have to go back and make sure you go down the cycle and jump back up and start again each time.